In this video, I'll show you how to take time-lapse photos on a Canon PowerShot SX30 IS. If you have a Canon PowerShot camera and you are able to install CHDK, this script should work for you. Click here if you need to learn more about installing CHDK. Here is an example of 50 shots taken at 30-second intervals. Step 1. Download the zip file that contains the intervalometer script. You can do that by going to this website, chdk.wikia.com/wiki/countdown_intervalometer. Scroll down until you find the CHDK countdown intervalometer script file. Step 2. Unzip the file. On a Mac, I recommend using STUFFIT EXPANDER, which is a free program you can download at stuffit.com. On a PC, you can right-click and use the default extraction tool. After unzipping the folder, you will notice a helpful text file that further explains how to use the script. Step 3. Drag and drop the script file onto your SD memory card. The name of the script is counter.bas. If you look at your memory card, there should be a folder called CHDK. Inside that folder, there should be another folder called script. You'll need to place the counter.bas file inside the script folder. Step 4. Safely eject the memory card and place it in the camera. Step 5. Turn on the camera using the card lock boot method or the firmware update method. Step 6. Press the shortcut Alt button to toggle to CHDK mode. Step 7. Press the function set button. Step 8. Select load script from file. Select counter.bas. Step 9. Choose your parameters. You can set the interval in seconds between each shot and the total number of shots in the sequence. Step 10. Exit the CHDK menu by pressing the menu button. You will notice the text countdown intervalometer blinking in the bottom left corner of the display. That means the script is ready to run. All you have to do is put the camera on a tripod, dial in your desired settings, and press the shutter button. The script will run until it reaches the number of shots you have selected, or until the battery dies, or until the memory card is full. Whichever comes first. You can also save parameter presets. This will save you time if you happen to use the same scripts repeatedly. This has been a how-to video with Big Nate 84. Thanks for watching.